हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आहूजा क्लासेस स्मार्टनेस इन एजुकेशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ यूक्लिड्स ज्योमेट्री, इन विच वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मेन एक्सियोम्स ऑफ द यूक्लिड विच आर द फाउंडेशन फॉर द ज्योमेट्रिकल एनालिसिस और द बेसिक ज्योमेट्री विच वी लर्न एट स्कूल लेवल। फर्स्ट, when we talk about the geometry, then geometry is basically a Greek word which has been derived from two parts. First is geo and second is metrein. Geo refers to the earth and metrein refers to the measure, means the measurement of earth in terms of area, length, breadth or any other dimension. So, geometry is basically the Greek word in which is composed of two parts, geo and metrein, and in which geo refers to the earth and metrein refers to the measure. So, measurement of earth in terms of area or in terms of dimensions is known as geometry. And Euclid was one of the first analyzer of the geometrical measurements or geometrical parameters, who founded the very basic definitions for the geometrical entities. Now, let us discuss about the definitions of Euclid, its axioms and postulates. See, a solid has shape, size in terms of three dimensions, position, and it can be moved from one place to another. And the boundaries of a solid are called surfaces. See, this is a solid in which this pink portion refers to a surface. This is also a surface. This is the backward surface. This is the leftward surface. This is the bottomward surface. So any solid is basically composed of a shape, size and position, and it can be moved from one place to another. Now let us talk about some fundamental definitions given by Euclid. Let us talk about point. A point is basically that geometrical entity which has no length, no breadth and no height, means which has no part. So point can be defined as a dimensionless geometrical entity. And when we come to talk about line, and line is a breadthless length, means a simple length in which breadth is absent is known as a line. The ends of a line are basically points, which is also known as line segment. And a straight line is a line which lies evenly with the points on itself. A straight line is basically refers to the line in which every point is present on a straight path. This is a line which can be extended in both the directions, and this is the line segment whose endpoints are basically certain points. Now, surfaces. What is a surface? A surface is that geometrical entity which has length and breadth only. And a plane surface refers to a surface which lies evenly with the straight lines. Plane surface basically lines on the straight lines. See, this is a surface, and the end edges are known as, and the end lines are known as edges. This is the edge of a surface. This is also an edge. This is also an edge. And this is the last edge. Now, let's discuss about the axioms of Euclid's geometry. First is, things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. If we take two equal things, then they will remain equal to themselves. Now, if equals are added to equals, then the wholes are equal. When we add the same length, same dimension to a particular dimension or particular value on both the sides or on the both the similar values, then we get the same answer. And similarly, if equals are subtracted from equals, then the remainders are also equal. Next is, the things which coincide with one another, those things which can coincide with each other are equal to one another. If we take two circles of the same radius, then they will coincide on each other and they will be equal to one another. Now, next is, the whole or the complete thing is greater than the part. This is obvious that a part of a complete object is always smaller than the complete object. Things which are double of the same things are equal to one another. Next is, things which are halves of the same things are equal to one another. These are converse of each other. Axiom number 6 and axiom number 7, both are converse of each other. Now, let us understand each and every axiom one by one. First is, things which are equal to the same thing are equal to one another. Let us suppose, if I take a line segment AB of length 5 centimeters, and if I take another line segment of the same length, suppose CD, then these two things are equal to the same thing, so they will be equal to each other. And if I take one more line, suppose EF, this is also 5 centimeters. Now, let us suppose EF is the line which is equal to AB and it is also equal to CD. EF is equal to AB and EF is also equal to CD. If AB is equal to EF and CD is equal to EF, then AB will be equal to CD. So, the things which are equal to the same thing, means AB and CD both are equal to EF, so that AB and CD will also be equal to each other. Next is, if equals are added to equals, the wholes are equal. Let us suppose, if I have a line segment AB of 5 centimeter length and I have another line segment of CD which is also of the length 5 centimeter, and suppose if I add a part of BX of length 2 centimeters to AB, and similarly if I add a part of 2 centimeters DY on CD, then AX will be equal to CY, and both will be equal to 7 centimeters. So if equals, that means BX and DY both are of equal length, they are added to the equals, that means of length 5 centimeters. This 2 centimeter length has been added on both the sides of 5 centimeters so that the holes, means the complete lengths, are equal now. Now, in the similar manner, if equals are subtracted from equals, the remainders are equal. Suppose I have a length AB of 5 centimeters. Similarly, I have another length CD of length 5 centimeters. And if we subtract equals from these two lengths, suppose if I subtract BX and DY equal to 2 centimeters from both the sides, then AX is equal to CY will remain equal to 3 centimeters. Now this length will be equal to 3 centimeters. So that if I subtract equals, that means 2 centimeters from equals, that means AB and CD, which are equal to both, which are equal to 5 centimeters, so that the remainders, that means AX and CY of length 3 centimeters, are equal to each other. Next is the things which coincide with one another. Suppose if I have two circles, first is having center O and radius R, and if I have another circle of the center O dash and radius R dash, these are coinciding on each other, means they are one above the another, then these are equal to each other. That means the radius of, that means the radius of both the circles are equal, R equals to R dash, or we can say that circles are equal to each other. Now, next axiom is the whole is greater than the part. That means, suppose if I take a square of sides 5 centimeters, and if I remove a square of sides 2 centimeters from it, that means this is the square of sides 2 centimeters, then we can say that this complete square will always be greater than this part. Suppose this square is ABCD and this internal one is BPQ, and suppose this point is R. So square ABCD is always greater than square BPQR, so that the whole is always greater than the part. Now, next axiom says things which are double of the same things. Those things which are double of the same things are equal to one another. Suppose if I have a length AB of size 5 centimeters and I have two another lengths suppose this is CD this is equals to 10 centimeter and one more length AF which is also equals to 10 centimeters here we can say that CD is double of AB and AF is also double of AB so that the things which are double of the same things that means there are two lengths CD and EF which are double of the same thing that means AB so that we can say that CD will be equals to EF now the converse of the above axiom is that the things which are halves that means those things which are just 1 by 2nd part of the same things are equal to one another suppose I have a length AB equals to 10 centimeters I have two another lengths CD which is equals to 5 centimeters and one more length that means EF which is also equals to 5 centimeters and we can say that CD is half of AB similarly EF is also half of AB so that CD will be equals to EF so this is the axiom is clear from this these two statements that the things that means CD and EF which are halves of the same things that means AB CD is half of AB similarly EF is also half of AB so that these are equal to one another that means CD and EF are equal to each other Thank you. In the next lecture, we will learn about the postulates formulated by Euclid.